Hey, hey everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Cube SMP Minecraft server. I have a cookie in my right hand. Can you see it? Look at it. It's so tasty. So anyway, guys, welcome back to another episode. Last time we worked on our little villager factory with Grape and Graser, and I wanted to do a lot of the stuff that I'm going to be doing in today's episode, but I didn't just have enough time. And I actually have another thing planned for today's episode involving Grape and Graser, so looks like I'm not going to be doing too much in today's episode, but hey, it's always going to be fun as always. So I did some AFKing at the XP farm, and I have these pants here, but I want to make myself a chest plate. I want to make myself some booties, and I want to make myself a helmet. I got a power 2 bow here because I don't have a bow. If you guys remember, I lost all my stuff a couple episodes back, and I'm going to have a go at enchanting this stuff and see what I get. Fire protection 3, ill gross. I don't want to enchant boots, not prot 3, no way. Helmet, projectile protection, are you freaking kidding? They're all like trash enchants. What about a book? Fortune 2, okay, let's get that on a book. Sweet. Let's do another guy. Unbreaking 3, come on, I want to get like prot 4 at least. Prot 3? What do I do, guys? What do I do? Okay, let's do Unbreaking 3. Dang it, just Unbreaking 3. What about this guy now? Unbreaking 3, do I risk it? Okay, let's do another one of these. Power 3. What else is up here? Aqua Affinity. Dang it, dude. Okay, let's just toss this guy in. Wait, what do I get on my boots if I do this? Oh, Feather Falling 4. That's perfect. Oh, Fire Protection 3. You serious? And then let's just do this. Bang. Oh, no, no, no. Oh! Why did I click that? Oh, well, that's that. It's still armor. It's good enough. Okay, so now I have Feather Falling 4, Fire Protection 3 boots. Let me toss these guys off and let's add the Depth Strider 3 to those guys. There we go. The anvil broke. Oh, no. Oh, no. I also need to combine these pants. What else do I have here? Oh, I have Sharpness 4 that I want to add to my sword, and I also want to combine these pants. Okay, let's head back to my place and let's use the anvil there. And then, dang it, dude, we didn't get the best of, we got like trash enchantments there. Oh, well, I'm almost still protected, so it'll stop us from dying, but hey, it's not the best, not the best. 15 levels or 13 levels, there we go. And how much does it cost to add Sharpness 4 to my sword? 4 levels, sweet, thank you very much. And what else can I do? What do I have here? I might add Protection 4 to my helmet. Let's see how much this guy costs. 4 levels, perfect. And then we're left with an Unbreaking 3 book, which I should try and add that to my boots. Guys, this actually didn't turn out too bad. Oops, wrong one. Unbreaking 3, 4 levels. Okay, so I'll just carry that on me, and I'll wait for myself to get 4 levels. Actually, I could probably get 4 levels just by pulling something out of a furnace over here. Let me see. Do I have anything in here? Aha! There we go, 4 levels. Thank you for the taters. And let's just plop this guy into here. Whereabouts are you? There we go. Like that, and like that. Bam! Woohoo! Full diamond armor again. We're getting back there, guys. Next thing is we just need a bow, and then we should be good with all of our enchantments again. Oh, it feels good to be back. Feels good to be back.
Hello, nobody, because oh, there he is. Straub. Hello, Grazer. Hello. How are you doing today?
I'm not doing too bad.
Why are we facing this way? Oh, he almost turned around.
I almost turned around. Well, I mean, I really, really, really dig this island with a tree right here. Can I reserve this for myself?
Yeah, go ahead.
This is
all
really
yours.
Cool looking. Thank you. I will take this.
Oh, I've been working on the villager factory.
Okay.
And I got us a base frame, and you haven't seen this, so I want you
to
give your honest
right now,
opinion.
Guys.
Go ahead.
Okay, I have not seen it at all yet. Oh, man, here we go. Tell me when, Grape.
Go ahead, dude. Whenever you want.
Wait, Grape, when should we look?
Go.
Grape, when should we look?
Is Grazer's head on backwards?
I'll look. 3, 2, 1.
Whoa!
Holy cow, that's like a lot bigger than I, like, in height than I thought it was gonna be. I thought
half
the height. So here's this completely changes my image on it now. So instead of like length, we're gonna be doing it by floors, is what we're
gonna do. Yeah, floors.
We also have room over here to extend as well. Don't forget about that.
I can make a tube that goes over here too.
Yeah, there could be like different centers in the whole laboratory. Oh, that's so sick. So I should probably mention now. Straub actually figured out how to do the minecart transportation system that will transport these villagers from the villager breeder over to here.
Oh, yeah, man.
Without the need for a tube, eh, Straub?
Tube, dude.
Whoa, Straub, it looks like you're bleeding everywhere. What's going on, man?
I'm bleeding! Oh, deja vu all over again, guys. All right, so what's up? We don't actually like to talk to each other. Why are we here today, friends?
Well, we're here today because, of course, as we don't like to talk to each other, there's got to be a reason. In the no, we're kidding. We love talking to each other. We love each other. Right,
I love
guys?
You, Graser.
Strav has been really weird lately, and I have not developed the skill or the degree on how to react to the weirdness yet. Like,
no, I don't think I've been
him.
Weird. I think you've just been more normal.
No, no, like, I'm always weird towards Straub, right? And he, yeah, he knows how to react to it, but I don't know how to react to him being weird to me. Like, I haven't been trained in that field because I'm not usually the reactant. I'm usually the producer of the weirdness. So we are here, guys, because as you guys all know, we're like the only three that are actually here on the server this week, other than Kermit, who's always on, of course.
He's
like
AFK,
a constant. He's a constant in the equation. When you want to equate how many people are on, he's always there. But the reason we are here all together today is because in the middle of the mainframe here, there's a dispenser. Ooh!
What
dispenser.
Is this?
Now, inside... we forgot to load it up. That's awkward. All right, we are back. It's raining now. It's filled up. So in this middle dispenser here, this dropper, there's a button. And if we look inside, there are wood blocks or wood planks that symbolize all Ooh. Of the 9 cube members who are at PAX South at this current moment in time. So if you're not familiar... There's a convention going on right now called PAX South, and half of the cube group, I think, about half, are there.
Nine.
So nine out of, no, because there's more than 18 now since season 2 started. So if we're in season, whoa, I don't have weather sounds on, but there was a strike that was right there. So if we're in season 1, it would be half.
Whoa,
the,
whoa.
We're gonna die, dude.
This thunderstorm is huge. It's this place, eh, guys? It's
yeah,
always
tainted.
Happens.
Whenever we're here, it always thunders.
Holy smokes. Okay. Right. Anyways, so there's 9 members that are at PAX South, and we thought, what better to... Wow, this thunderstorm. Whoa, jeez, holy cow.
Talk.
Go.
What better way to prank, or what better time to prank than now, when all of them are gone? So what we're going to do is we are going to have a pranking competition between Grape, Straub, and I, and what's going to happen is, for this episode, we are going to come up to this dispenser... Click the button, get a name, think of a prank, then go into our own episodes, execute the prank, and come back, and then we're going to show each other our pranks in all of our episodes, and then you guys are going to vote. We're all going to have a straw poll in the description of our videos where you guys are going to be able to vote for which one of us you thought had the best prank. So, it's the pranking competition. It's kind of like what Straub and I did a while back
with the Halloween festival.
Where we determined and we fought to see who could come up with the best Halloween, like, I don't know what to call it.
Best Halloween thing.
Yeah. So it's really, I'm thinking we might find a supercharged creeper today.
Dude,
guys.
I've kept my eye on this creeper over here in the water, like, all this clip. And there's another creeper in the forest over there. I'm waiting.
Right,
should we draw?
I think yeah. Grape wants to get right into it, Straub, so I think we should delay him a bit more, talk more about the thunderstorm.
All right, so you can actually see the lightning striking and hitting the ground.
I got H-bomb!
Oh!
All right, nice, dude.
Gets H. Okay, you next, Straub.
Okay.
Next.
Oh!
I got D-field!
Ooh. No! Alright,
the big D!
I've
pranked D-field like everyone's pranked D-field. The poor guy's getting pranked like a.
His house is right at spawn, so he's pranking.
Alright, guys, here I go.
Ooh!
Oh, who did I get? I don't want to reveal it yet.
Do I reveal it
to you or do I reveal it to my audience first in my episode?
Ooh. Yeah.
Alright, let's check.
Yeah.
Oh. Can you guys
All right,
guess
just kill
who
him
I got?
Let's find out. Kill him. Yeah.
take a little bit of a guess. Take a little bit of gander. Go for it.
Is it what you had in your hand a few seconds ago?
Is he Canadian?
Put it back in your hand, the item, the other one.
The other one? What do you mean?
The one you're holding when you pulled that, when you looked at what it was. Nope.
This?
Nope.
This?
Nope.
Oh, this!
Oh, it's Russia, it's Russia!
How did you do that? Yeah, so I got Russia, Straub got D-Field, and Grape got H, and we are all going to go and do a prank on them right now,
Ooh.
And at the end of the episode, we're all going to go and show each other our pranks, and you guys are going to vote. And then you guys are going to vote who has the best prank. So this should be a pretty cool episode. So you guys ready to prank?
Mm-hmm. Let's do this.
Let's do this! Prank Wars!
Yeah.
All right, guys. So we are pranking D-Field, the big D, again. We've done two pranks on the server, I think, and both of them have been on D-Field. And I know with all the whole Prank Brothers thing, that's kind of being held on, it's kind of been put on hold right now because me and Russia can't do anything right now because we're not together and we haven't really been able to talk for the past couple of weeks just because like our schedule has been conflicting. So P Brothers should be back once Russia gets back from PAX, but right now we're just going to have some fun pranking and putting the P Brothers on a little bit of hold. And we also got to work on that base a bit more. So my prank on Mark, Mark has already been pranked by Will. I'm not going to spoil that prank, but Mark is a big horse lover. Mark loves his horse. If you mess with D-Field's horse, he gets mad. And I was actually going to do that, but his horse is already gone. So we're going to do something else here. And this is actually a prank idea that I came up with not too long ago. And if you guys know what it is, and you guys probably already saw the title of the video. So what it is it's going to be a Trojan horse. And not Trojan is what you think Trojan means, but like Trojan is like something that's let me look this word up. Trojan often acts as a backdoor, contacting a collector, which can have unauthorized access to the affected computer. Well, basically, if you look up Trojan on Google, it comes up with a bunch of like malware virus stuff. And basically, the Trojan virus or malware is it disguises itself as something. So it appears to be one thing, and then once you open it up, oh, it's a virus. Great. So it could be like, protect your computer quickly, and then you like go, oh crap, and then you install the virus protection that has been downloaded onto your computer. Because it's like, quickly install this, otherwise your computer will have viruses, and then bam, you've got a virus that downloads all your banking details, and then you lose all your money because it's a Trojan and it's somehow tricked you. And where that word comes from is some time long ago. Basically what happened was it was like some sort of like war. Someone got delivered a giant horse, let the horse into their base or whatever, and then once they opened up the horse, a bunch of army guys came out and killed everyone. So that's kind of what my plan of attack was with this guy. I don't really know though. I don't really know what I can do. I can't really fill it up with mobs because he'll hear it, and I'm thinking about just filling it with TNT, and then he just pulls the lever, and then it kind of kills him. Hopefully, that's what I'm hoping. But we'll see what we can do here. I've got some blocks to work with. I need to go get some clay. And I'm going to try and make it look like his horse, Kenny, a little bit. But I don't really know how to build horses. And I don't think this is going to turn out the best. But I'll see what I can do in the next, like, you know, in the next amount of time. So I will jump right back in a quick second, guys, once I've done some building. And I hope I explained that Trojan thing good enough. If not, go Google it, guys, because I'm not good at explaining things. Good morning, peasants. Welcome to thy castle. Bow good down evening. To King good evening, Strubber.
Actually, it's morning, I believe, fellow peasants. It's morning. Good morning, Mike.
Good morning. Good mythical morning. All right, so guys, this isn't actually my castle. I'm kidding. This is actually King D's castle. But I have devoured a prank against D-Field like you guys have done against the people you're pranking your episodes. And you guys know that D-Field likes his horse, and he has the castle. So I decided to go with an ancient prank from the back in the old times. Ooh. And I delivered him a giant horse, a Trojan horse.
A Trojan horse.
Oh, what's inside it, Straub?
Nothing. It's only one block wide because I couldn't. It actually looks, it's kind of skinny right now. I might have to fatten him up a bit.
Skinny horse.
Grazer, get that back. What are you doing? Why are you taking that, Grazer? Dude, why do you want that? Put it back. That's that guy's thing-a-ling, dude. Come on. It's a pretty simple prank. Do you guys have anything I can add to it? Like, I don't know what to add to it. Like, I'm thinking about making this, like, see how his legs are there? I'm thinking about making him, like, fat in the middle.
Changes hooves to like, a different color.
Leap of faith!
Okay.
You still missed it.
Yeah, but I don't know. I'm thinking about filling. Would you guys think it's bad if I like sort of fill up his insides a bit more and like fill it with TNT so he pulls the lever? Like he's like, haha, why is there a lever here, Strom? You're so mature. Then bam, it just blows up.
Okay, I would agree with that if you put like just a one TNT in there so it won't blow up his castle. It'd be like a scare.
Oh, yeah, maybe I could, like just, in put the middle in, I could just put it inside the legs right there. That wouldn't have been too hard to do. Yeah, I'll just plop it right in there. That's perfect. All right, sweet. But that's it for my prank. Hopefully D-Field gets mad because I don't want to do anything too bad because Will already pranked him. But I don't know. This is something that I wanted to do for a while and I thought it was pretty funny. Now we're going to go check out Grazer and Grape's pranks. If you guys want to see them, you can go check out their episodes. Or if you're watching my episode last, it's kind of awkward because you've already seen it. But hey, go check out their episodes nonetheless. And let's move on, boys.
All right, guys. So we've seen all of our pranks now. If you haven't seen them, go to our video. Straub's video will showcase Straub's prank. Grape's video will showcase Grape's prank. And my video will showcase my prank. So if you want to see all of them, go to our videos. Now, if you've seen all of them, it's time for you to vote.
It is time to vote on the straw poll.
There will be a straw poll in all of our descriptions. It will be the exact same straw poll link. We're not going to have different ones. We're just going to copy paste the same one. It'll be the same poll throughout all of our videos. It's your chance now to go and vote for who you think is the best prankster while everybody is gone to PAX South. And who do you think, or who you think will react in the most urgent and panicked way at their prank? So that is that.
Yeah. Here we go.
So go vote down below. And there's the vote.
Thanks, dude. I'm gonna go vote now.
Wait, who's on the server? Oh, okay. Oh, it's just Will, but Will knows what's up, so he's not gonna question it. Go vote on the straw poll. It'll be in the description too. And I can't wait to see the results. And now we are going to go ahead and end off our episodes.
All right, guys, we're joined by Super Steve here. Not really. Okay, so Planet TNT in the horse's dingling long. And, oh, his King Tong. King Dong. And then let's put that there like that. And then we'll put down the lever. And it, okay, it's doing that. That's kind of weird. Don't touch it. Don't get near it. Don't do anything. Ah, stop. Okay. Okay, and then let's put down a sign saying, hey, Big D. That's right. Hey, Big D. That's right. Hey, D-Field. I know it sucks that Kenny went missing, so here is a new horse. And, hopefully he can appreciate the horse. Hopefully he, attempts to maybe play with this thing. I don't really know yet, but, that's my goal, is to get him to flip that lever, and then that will set off the TNT. But, that is it for this prank. And if you guys want me to prank anyone else in the future, I just totally, like, slid out of my chair because I was, like, sunk into it. If you guys want me to prank anyone in the future, leave a comment down below. But, there's another prank on D-Field. Hopefully we can prank someone in the future, and hopefully it's with Russia next time. But, this looks good. Ha ha! Trojan horse! Ha ha ha! Alrighty, everyone, now that all the pranking is out of the way of this episode, hopefully that's what you all came to see, and hopefully you guys will stick with me for the last third or so of the episode, because what are we at, like 17 minutes and 17 seconds in or so? I think, I don't know, I'm just making an assumption. So before I finish off everything, why can't I hear that? Oh, there we go. I can hear sound. Before I finish off my episode, there's a few things that I want to update you guys on, and there's a couple of things that I want to buy. Let me just... I'm keeping a good eye on this creeper because he's freaking... Oh, my God. He's freaking going to blow me up. Okay. Let's take out the Amandas. Out. Don't do it. Don't do it. And... Oh! Okay, there we go. What's up, Kermit? Kermit restocked Kermit, and he has Sharp 5 now, but my sword is only Sharp 4, and I don't think I want to waste 7 diamonds on Sharp 5. It's not that big a deal. It's only, like, what? Like 1.25 more attack damage. He also stocked up on name tags, I think. Yeah, holy crap, he stocked up on name tags. Does he have looting books now? I didn't think he had looting before. Or do I have a looting? I'm not too sure. I think I'll grab one of those, which is 5 Diamondes. And then also, I want to grab a... I already got Feather Falling 4. Whereabouts is it? Oh, he has Efficiency 5 now. I wouldn't mind getting an efficiency 5 and unbreaking 3. So what's that? 5 plus 6. So that would be 11. I want to come in here and get some, you guys know what I want, some iron. Bam. And he has 6 stacks of that. Awesome. So I'm going to take all that, which is going to be another 12 diamonds. So thank you very much, Kermit, for your freaking shop. I always purchase from here, like, every other day or so. So, there we go. Let's make sure that actually goes in the hopper so you can, you know, get it. 1, 2, 3. There we go. Nice. And now I'm going to head back home. Oh, vote for Kermit. Let's not do that. Now I'm going to head back home and show you guys what I've done around home. And with all this iron, I should hopefully have enough iron to finish off my beacon at home and get a full powered beacon and hopefully get speed too so I can whiz around all over the place. And I've also done some building on my house and stuff to check out. So let's head on over there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we're back over here by the Straub, Casa de Straub, and over by the iron farm. I've done a little bit of AFKing, so there's a little bit more iron it for us. I think I get about 20 iron per an hour. So every time I pull 20 iron out of there, you guys know how long I've been AFK there for. So quite a while. And if I walk into my house, you guys are going to see a few changes. So I'm actually going to go in from the back here first, and then I will enter through the front. So there's not really anything that's been changed around here. If I look over here, you might notice that stuff's been cleaned up a little bit. I made this table a little bit cleaner. I added some glowstone around the TV to brighten up the room a bit more. And I've added paintings. And so behind all these paintings here, let me break this here. There's glowstone, because what I want to do is, because this house is like sort of, you know, like modern-y style, I don't want to put any torches down. I don't want to have any torches because they're like cavey, you know what I mean? And so I just want to use like glowstone, or, you know, I want to hide the lighting behind paintings. So every painting that you see has like hidden lighting behind it. I think this is this. No, this lab doesn't have anything behind it. So yeah, that's what I've done up here. Nothing's really changed over on this guy. This room still needs to be tweaked a little bit. Something just needs to be changed about it. I don't know what it really is there. I might add, maybe we need to add like some glass or something. I don't know. This wall just seems so bland. Maybe we should try and add some glass there. Maybe that might work. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what we can do. See, that just looks better already, having that gone. But if we come downstairs, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, this painting changed because I accidentally knocked it down. But yes, we have some, we have a little bit more house design. So I've added a little nice dining table in here. Of course, there's only two seats because it's just me and my pretty lady, which doesn't exist yet. And then we've got this nice little, like, what's it called? I saw this on the Water Corrales server. Uh-oh. What? Why is the music Yo, shut up! That's so awkward. Freaking Sony Vegas was running in the background. I actually left it playing, and once it hit like the end of the video, the outro music started playing. And I was like, wait, what the heck? Why is that even... So anyway, I saw this little design on the Water Crawler server, and you know, that's where I have a lot of my designing heavily gets inspired from. So yeah, I built this guy here. Looks pretty cool. Got this guy in here. I got rid of this little guy down here that led underground. I'm eventually gonna build a proper staircase leading down into the basement, and then eventually gonna finish up the basement and make it look, you know, good. Because that's like obviously a goal. And then I just got to do my kitchen and my bedroom, and then this house is complete, which I'm kind of excited for. But yeah, I'll probably hold off on that until like another week, until I get some more designing inspiration done. And now that I have, why do I have so much snow on me? What the heck? Where did I get all this snow from? Wait a second. Did I break something? Oh yeah, I did this. My bad. I'm so stupid. Aha! There we go. That looks better. Anyway, so what was I saying? Now that I have a bunch of iron on me, I'm gonna head down into my beacon, and I've come prepared. I have... What? Straub has come prepared to something? Yes, believe it or not. If I come down here, it's already been cleared out. So I've obviously been adding some iron to this already. I actually took a little bit of iron off the falcon to add to this guy, because I really wanted this beacon to get finished. It was just bugging me that it wasn't getting finished. So I just gotta add this final touches down here. It takes what, like 81 iron blocks to do this bottom layer, so this does take a while. And then if I go up to the top here, I don't think, do I have any colors on top of mine? No, I don't have any colors. It's just white. I know, I like the white beacon. The other colors kind of irk me a little bit. But if we do this, and then, oh wait, we need to select it first. X, wait, no. Okay, oh, there we go, speed 2. Oh, wait, I don't think we even need to put a thing into it, don't we? It should just become speed 2. Oh, wait, no, I gotta put a thing into it. Bam, there we go. Bloop! We shall get the speed 2! Woohoo! And this should last us. Let's see how far out this can reach, because if this reaches, like, all the way over to, like, our little, like, factory facility area that we're working on, that's pretty cool, because then if Grape puts his beacon, like, a little bit closer, and I think we're gonna have a... Oh, no, it runs out, like, around here, doesn't it? Dang, where does it like start though? Where does it start? So it starts like right here, then it starts to fade away here, right? When we hit 5, 4, oh no, around here somewhere. But if we get a beacon like right like towards the front of the factory, I think we'll get one outside the front or maybe in the central area of the factory. We should be able to get speed 2 from like our place to out here to there. And then if Grazy gets his to speed 2, we should get it around there. And then we can get one for Grape, and then we can put another one on this central island here. Dude, we get speed 2 all over the place. That's going to be sick. Oh, I'm so excited for that. But anyway, guys, I think that is going to be about it for today's episode of the Cube SMP. There's a sign here. What does this say? If your name is Straub, you're ugly. That's it. I'm fludging done, dude. How the heck did he already prank me back? Like, he already pranked me back and he's not even here. Nah, I think that sign's been there for a while. But that's gonna be it for today's episode of The Cube. There will be a brand new episode out for tomorrow, and that is a promise, because next weekend, I'm gonna be uploading a super special episode for episode 25. And that should be out like on the weekend, I think. And we're going to do a double length episode. So be sure to look out for that. It's going to be 48 minutes long, not just the regular 24, which shall be fun. And we can do some fun things in that. But that is going to be it for today. So if you guys enjoyed this episode, be sure to stop it a like. It helps out a stack. And yeah, that is about it. I messed up my outro. So I just knocked over a bowl of water. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.